Welcome back to Healthy Planet, Healthy Me. I'm Sherry Beall. Let's take a moment here to get a solid stance and get grounded before we step out into our day and our future with some words of wisdom and encouragement from Gurmukh Kaur Khalsa, author and the co-founder of Golden Bridge Yoga. She's also the co-director, the premier center for the study and practice of Kundalini Yoga and meditation here in Los Angeles, California. For over 3 decades, students in the Los Angeles area and around the world have sought her classes in Kundalini Yoga, meditation, and pre- and postnatal care. Her husband of, I believe, 26 years, Guru Shabad, is also a yoga teacher, and they have a very cool and beautiful daughter named Wa. And I believe she's 24, but we'll find out. I apologize if I'm off for that. So, Sat Nam Gurmukh.
Sat Nam, Sherry. Thank you once again for inviting me.
Sure thing. What can you share with us for those who have never taken yoga or who take it sometimes? How can that help us out get through this time period?
It's a way to feel better, to have energy, to get beyond your fears, to get beyond your mind that might be locked in fear. It's gives you freedom. It gives you wings to fly, and it happens to every single person that does it. It's a promise, but you have to do it. You can't just read about it. You have to do it.
But it's an ancient practice. I'm talking about Kundalini right now.
It is the oldest form of healing. It's a healing. It's a science of angles and breath. And it isn't like we hope it works. It's a science. We know it works. What happens in the 9 months in your womb, in your mother's womb, and the first 3 years sets you for the rest of your life. And some of us did not get set too well. So you start yoga at 30, 40, 50, 60 years old, and you undo that past history that has blocked you. And how do you know? You feel more free. You feel more happy. Prosperity comes to you. You don't worry so much. You sleep better at night. Your food choices are better. Everything unfolds like a peacock feather. And how? Through your breath and through knowing that you start leaving the old to see what's brand new right in front of you. It's like a miracle.
We have the great honor right now to be joined with Krishna Kaur. She's a yoga teacher and teacher trainer for over 30 years. She's the founder and director of Yoga for Youth and president of the International Association of Black Yoga Teachers. Krishna is currently training yoga teachers in Africa who will establish yoga for youth programs. Welcome to Healthy Planet, Healthy Me, Krishna Kaur.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much for inviting me to be with you, Sherry. You're just an amazing spirit.
Thank you. You know why? Because I get to interview people like you, and it's great. So tell us a little bit about the history and some incidents of people that you've really been able to affect their lives, some youth.
Well, when I first started going into the institutions, people kept saying, well, what are you going to do? You've never done drugs before. You've never been a gangbanger. You know, how are these kids going to relate to you? You know, and I said, well, because I'm going to come from my truth and I'm going to just be myself and what happens, happens. And I was amazed and I'm still amazed at how many young people get it. They have the opportunity to do yoga for one class and it shifts something dramatic inside of them. The key turns on, and technically speaking, what happens, this is a science and it is an art. The science is that, yes, the angles are there. They create a pressure on certain meridian points in the body. They stimulate the secretion and activate the secretion of the glands. Organs and glands become more active. They become more balanced. Circulation becomes better. The mind-body spirit connection is like a synchronization. Yes, you said unity earlier on in the show. It's all about bringing all the parts of the self together in a harmonious way so they can function efficiently and effectively to achieve the desired result, which is one of being peaceful, of being whole, and of being able to see and be yourself, as Gurmukh said. It's like connecting with you. Will the real you stand up? Will the real you really come forth and flower? Because until that happens, then none of us are going to be really very safe or very happy because we're not getting all from each other that we're destined to get. Mm-hmm. One kid came to me one day. This is a story that I tell often.
Yeah. Yeah.
I walked onto the campus of one of the detention facilities out in Malibu. Mm-hmm. And this big kid runs across the campus, you know, on the grass. And he's saying, "Miss, miss, miss, ma'am, yoga lady, yoga lady." You know, I said, what is it that he's wanting? You know, why is he running like this after me? And he says, I did it. I said, "Yeah, what did you do?" He said, "I didn't hit him."
Oh.
I didn't hit him.
Huh.
I did that long, deep breathing stuff you showed me, and I didn't hit him.
Wow.
And I said, "That's it." Now, that guy experienced another way to be powerful. So that's it.
Absolutely.
That's what it's all about.
Now, we're going to hear from Hala Khouri. She's a somatic counselor, yoga teacher, and community activist. She is co-creator of a project called Off the Mat, Into the World, which aims at getting yoga practitioners active in their communities on a grassroots level. Her personal passion is bringing yoga to at-risk youth and training yoga teachers. So I'd like to welcome to Healthy Planet, Healthy Me, Hala Khouri.
It's so great to be here and such an honor to be here with these two lovely ladies, Gurmukh and Krishna Kaur. Thank you, Sherry.
Absolutely. I'd like you to tell us about what you're doing around the U.S. and then I believe you went to Africa and
mm-hmm.
And I just saw this enormous number of youth doing yoga with you guys. So please tell us about your organization.
It's a movement that we're sparking in the yoga community. When people practice yoga, like these two women have been explaining, something inside of us lights up and our bodies become more healed, our minds become more balanced. And oftentimes, the next stage of that is to share it with others. Otherwise, like I say, you can just keep manifesting your own injuries and problems. And when your yoga gets stuck on your mat, it can get very stuck. So the natural next step towards the awakening that we get with yoga is to share it with others. And when we share it with others, we then spread that healing and that heals us. There's a really beautiful saying, and I'm going to misquote it, but something around giving is not giving yourself away. It's allowing the energy of nature and spirit to move through you and enjoy the sensation of its passage.
Mm-hmm.
So can you enjoy the sensation of giving?
Did anyone want to say any closing comments or mention your website? Go ahead.
Our website is
Hala Khouri.
Our website is offthematintotheworld.org. And it's just a pleasure to be here and a pleasure to see how significant and important yoga is becoming, and I think more and more, in the consciousness, especially of Americans, because we're really paving the way in terms of the global consciousness, whether we like it or not, especially here in California and Los Angeles. So thrilled to be here.
Thank you, Krishna Kaur.
Yes, www.yogaforyouth.org. And I just want to say that all these kids belong to us. Let's take care of them because they're the future.
Gurmukh?
Just feeling good today. And thank you so much, Sherry. GoldenBridgeYoga.com. God bless us all.
I'd like to thank our guests on today's show, Gurmukh of Golden Bridge Yoga, Krishna Kaur, and Hala Khouri. And thanks to you, our listeners. Happy New Year. We'll see you next week. Be well.